Holy Spirit, the peace of the risen Lord be with you always. Good morning, everyone. Despite wielding the sword of persecution with great gusto, there are still many people impressed by the apostles' preaching of the word, and so they come to faith and to baptism and the celebration of the sacraments. We remember today those Catholics who are still being persecuted, and yet despite such persecution and difficult circumstances, still remain faithful to Christ, his church, and his gospel. Like Mary at the empty tomb, we fail to grasp the wonder of your presence. Lord, have mercy. Like the disciples behind locked doors, we are afraid to be seen as your followers. Christ, have mercy. Like Thomas in the upper room, we are so slow to believe. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who set St. Catherine of Siena on fire with divine love in our contemplation of the Lord's Passion and our service of your Church, grant through her intercession that your people, participating in the mystery of Christ, may ever rejoice in the revelation of his glory. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. That day, a bitter persecution started against the church in Jerusalem, and everyone except the apostles fled to the country districts of Judea and Samaria. There were some devout people, however, who buried Stephen and made great mourning for him. Saul then worked for the total destruction of the church. He went from house to house, arresting both men and women and sending them to prison. Those who had escaped went from place to place preaching the good news. One of them was Philip, who went to a Samaritan town and proclaimed the Christ to them. The people united in welcoming the message that Philip preached, either because they had heard of the miracles he worked, or because they saw them for themselves. There were, for example, unclean spirits that came shrieking out of many who were possessed, and several paralytics and cripples were cured. There was great rejoicing in the town as a result. The work of the Lord. Cry out with joy to God, all the earth. Cry out with joy to God, all the earth. O sing to the glory of his name. O render him glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous your deeds. Before you all the earth shall bow, shall sing to your name. Come and see the works of God, tremendous his deeds among men. He turned the sea to dry land, they passed through the river dry shod. Let our joy be in him, he rules forever by his might. comes to me will never be hungry. He who believes in me will never thirst. But as I have told you, you can see me, and still you do not believe. All that the Father gives me will come to me, and whoever comes to me, I shall not turn away. Because I have come from heaven, not to do my own will, but to do the will of the one who sent me. Now the will of the one who sent me is that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I should raise it up on the last day. Yes, it is my Father's will that whoever sees the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up at the last day. The Gospel of the Lord. The communion that Jesus offers is a life shared with himself and his Father. For the Jews, God was totally other, distant, to be feared and obeyed. For Jesus, all that is turned around. The Father invites you to a life of intimacy, to be shared with himself, his Son, and his Spirit. Catherine of Siena, whom we remember today, was one such disciple who got that. In the 14th century, she devoted herself as a youngster to prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. Her life was like one long, intense period of Lenten effort, an effort that she never relaxed. She became a Dominican sister, shared a lot about her prayer life, advised people on their spiritual journeys, and supported the Avignon popes, encouraging them to return to Rome. However, her interior life is the most important thing for our consideration. She advised perseverance in prayer. Experience of the Risen One comes if you work at it. She was very conscious of God working in her, sensitive to his presence in her life and in her work. She recognized the periods of prayer and charitable acts were both parts of your spiritual life, offering the events of your day as a living sacrifice of prayer and worship to God. Prayer for her was living life in communion with God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Accept, Lord, the sacrifice we offer in commemoration of St. Catherine, so that, instructed by her teaching, we may give ever more fervent thanks to you, the one true God. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with Easter joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as together we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Father, you are holy indeed, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Christ has died,
alleluia. Christ is risen,
alleluia.
Christ will come again,
alleluia, alleluia.
Father, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son's death and resurrection, we offer you the bread of life and the cup of eternal salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be here in your presence and minister to you. We pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your people spread throughout the world, and bring us to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Philip our own Bishop, and all your people, religious and clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, her husband Joseph, the apostles, and all the saints, whose lives have pleased you down throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs with them to eternal life, and to be praised and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait in joyful hope the return of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, after your resurrection, you appeared to your disciples with the greeting, "Peace be with you." Look not in our sins, but in our faith, and grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the risen Lord be with you always. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, fill my heart, unite us as one. Never let me be parted from you. Amen. May the heavenly table at which we have been fed, Lord, confer eternal life upon us, as even in this world it is nourished the life of St. Catherine. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Mass tomorrow morning will be at the usual time of 10 a.m. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, that has known the peace of the risen Lord.